hope you're all fine. It's very nice to see you one more week for Ritmico's music classes. And we're gonna say hello as well to our friend Isidoro the Cocodrile. Isidoro? Isidoro! There you are! Hello, Isidoro! Join me? Hello everyone, it's nice to see you. Now we're going to do some blue yellow cards, but today we're going to do it a bit differently. Today I would like you to get a small percussion instrument. Okay, I'm going to see if I've got some in my magic bag. Let's see what I can find. Ooh! This is fantastic! It's like a tambourine. Great! I think I'll use that. Have you all got your instruments ready? Okay, let's practice a little bit. So, let's say, for example, four cellos with your percussion instruments. Ready? Ready, steady, here we go! Cello, 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 cello. Well done. Should we now say two pineapples? Are you ready? Ready, steady, here we go. Pineapple, pineapple. Well done. Great. And now let's say a two. You ready? Ready, steady, here we go. Two. Nice, well done. Okay, you're ready. Let's go and play with the cards. Okay, have your instruments ready. Ready, steady, off we go. Blue, blue, two, blue. And drop, and flop. And rest, rest, rest. Pineapple. Oh. And drop, plop, squish. Oh, this is my favorite card. It's like pineapple juice. Ready, steady, off we go. Pineapple, 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 pineapple. And drop, and plop. And squish, and pineapple, 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 rest, jello, and drop, and flop, and squish, ready, and rest, blue, pineapple, jello, jello, and drop, and flop, and squish. Pineapple to rest. And we're now going to be joined by Catherine, who's going to be singing the Daily Dose song with us. See you in a minute.
Hello, everybody. I hope everyone is doing really well. My name is Catherine, and today we are going to be doing the Daily Dose song together. So what's going to happen is I'm going to sing the first bit of the song using the hand signs, and then afterwards I'm going to sing it again, and that time see if you guys can join in with me. So here we go. So me, so me, so la, so me, do. You guys, get your hands ready. Here we go. So me, so me.
Hi everyone, this is called Soft Kitten. So for Soft Kitten, we actually need our soft toy. So I don't have a kitten. This is, I wonder if you know what animal this is. It's got the two antlers here. This is a deer. And our deer is all snuggled up. Maybe you can see. So I'm going to use deer. Pretend that she's a kitten for now. So if you haven't already, go and find a soft toy that you have. It doesn't have to be a kitten, it could be a teddy bear, just something that you can do the actions with. But to start off with, I'll say the rhyme all the way through. Soft kitten, warm kitten, little ball of fur. Lazy kitten, sleepy kitten, purr, purr, purr. So I'll count us in and we'll start off saying it all together. So, soft toy at the ready. Ready, steady, here we go. Soft kitten, warm kitten, little ball of fur. Lazy kitten, sleepy kitten, purr, purr, purr. Well done.
The song that we're going to listen to now is called Letterador and it's from Carmen. Carmen was written by Georges Bizet, a French composer that wrote this opera in 1875. This song, in particular, is called Letterador, which means bullfighters. And it's going to be talking about bullfighters just coming out and fighting the bulls. So it's all going to be very, very energetic and very exciting. For this, I've picked three colors. You can pick any three colors that you would like, okay? And we're going to start by preparing the score. So we're going to have a first part that is going to repeat a few times. So I'm going to start by drawing a repeat sign. You do that by drawing two lines with two dots. And then at the end of the page, another two lines with the dots in the other side. Okay, and remember the music starts here, goes all this way, boom, bounces, and goes back here again. Okay, so we're going to be listening to some cymbals playing really loudly and the whole orchestra really, really excited as all the bulls and the bullfighters come out. Next, we're going to have a different section where we're going to hear some trumpets and other instruments. So we're going to have this section here. I'm just going to draw two lines, okay, preparation for it. And then we're going to listen to some music growing louder and louder and louder and louder. And in here, at this point, those are two lines. And at this point, the music is gonna go back to the beginning. So in order for me to note that down, I'm gonna draw a little sign here and a little sign here, okay? And then finally, there's going to be a section where the horses come out, okay? And they're going to be doing some small steps to start with, and then they're going to be doing some very big steps, okay? So I'm going to draw all this part here. And we're going to actually here even go back to the beginning again. And then we're going to finish with a big finale. So I think I've got everything laid out here. Let's listen to the song. Have all your pens ready. And we're going to start with the first color. Okay, ready? ¶¶ Joined by Sophie, who's going to be doing some instruments with you. Sing a bit.
Hello, I'm Sophie from Ritmico Music, and today I'm going to talk to you about the flute. So this is a flute. It's really long and not heavy at all. It might seem heavy because you can play it for a long time and it can feel heavy, but it's not heavy. It's made up of three different sections, so this is called the head joint, the body and the end. And when you take them apart, we've got the head joint, the body, and then just the end of it there. So the oldest flute ever discovered is thought to have been made from bone, and it had 2 to 4 holes in it. And is said to be around 43,000 years old. So it's a very old flute and not as amazing and modern as the flutes that we have today. So the flute is kind of similar to the recorder and that it was once made out of wood, and you can still get wooden flutes today. You can see a lot of professionals sometimes playing older pieces by Bach or Vivaldi. Played on wooden flutes, because originally, back in the times when Vivaldi, Bach and Mozart composed those pieces, that was the only instrument available to them. So sometimes nowadays professional players will play those pieces with an instrument that was similar to what it would have been played on back when it was first written, just to give it a more authentic sound. So the wooden flute had open holes on it, so it didn't have any buttons on it like our flutes today do. That's how it's similar to a recorder, because it didn't have any holes. It would only have one little mechanism near the end, and that was for your pinky. So the flute is part of the woodwind family. When the woodwind family is made up of the flute, the saxophone, the clarinet, the oboe and bassoon. So it slots right in with them. So we'll talk about the head joint. So on the head joint you see a lip plate, and that's just where the player blows from. So it fits in between the top of your chin and like the bottom of your lip, because there's a little indent there. So that's where you would place the lip plate. So it just sits nicely in here. So to play the flute, you don't blow into it. So you play the flute by blowing over it. That's why it sits in here, because you're going to blow over. And you need to take big breaths, because a lot of your air actually goes that way instead of going down the flute. So about 40% of your big breath, so only some of it actually goes into the flute, so you need big, big breath to play it. We can do a lot of things just with the head joint before we even put it all together to play. and it should make a weird, funny, high-pitched sound. If you want to make different sounds with the head joint, you can cover your hand. You can cover the end with your hand. And you can also take your finger and you can wiggle it inside and it'll make some funny noise too. So the buttons that you see on the flute are actually called keys. And there's quite a lot of them. There's 16 different keys and they all do something different, and sometimes the same one key can control a couple others. So to start playing, you just want your hands kind of like this. It's kind of like the recorder, where you have your hands over the three holes, and then again down the three holes, and then your pinky just kind of sits here. And then instead of playing it down the way, we flip it over. So that is the best way to have your hands. So the fingering on the flute is pretty much similar to the recorder. In fact, it's pretty much the same. If you play the recorder, you'll know it goes B, A, G with 1, 2, 3. And it's the same on the flute. It goes B, A, G, 1, 2, 3. You have little keys at the side here just for different notes. So the flute can play 3 different octaves, starting from a very low C or a low Do up to a very high Do. And an octave is just 8 notes. So it goes Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. And then it starts again, Do, Re, Mi. So it can play 3 different scales. So I'll just give you an example of one scale, which is the low Do to a high Do. So there are also different members of the flute family. There's the flute, and then, so this is kind of the middle ground. But you also have a piccolo, which is slightly smaller, and it can play a lot higher than the flute. And then you have an alto flute, which is the middle flute, and it's just a little bit deeper than the flute, slightly bigger. And then you have a bass flute, which is like a bass guitar or a double bass. It sounds lower. So I'm going to give you an example of a flute piece that I like to play. It's composed by Bach, so it would have been written for a wooden flute. It's Bach's flute sonata in E minor, and I'm playing the third movement, which is the andante. Yeah, I just really like the piece. And I hope you guys do too. Thank you. I'm Sophie from Ritmico Music, and I hope you enjoyed this video.
Bye.
And now we're going to play a couple of games on the piano, okay? And you need everybody to stand up as we're going to be moving around the room. Make sure you've got some space around you, okay? And first of all, we're going to play a game that is called Stand Up and Sit Down. And it's got two very simple commands. First of all, is this. Stand up. Yeah? And sit down. Well done. Okay. Everybody ready? Good. Let's play. Ready? Stand up. For this game, I need everybody to imagine that you're little frogs, okay? And these little frogs are sometimes swimming very peacefully. And this is a frog swimming very peacefully. Okay, very, very slowly on the pond. But sometimes, the frog will see something, maybe a fly, maybe a mosquito, and then it jumps. And how high can the frog jump? Can you show me how you jump? Let's try it. Even higher. Well done. Okay, so let's swim and jump. Okay, here we go. Just now is called Meditation, and it was written by Jules Massenet. He wrote an opera called Ties, and in this opera is where you find this little intermezzo that is called Meditation, and it's written for solo violin and orchestra. In this story, Ties has to take a very, very difficult decision. So she goes into some very, very deep thinking. That's what we do when we meditate. So this music describes that process of really, really thinking to take the right decision. So for this, I'm gonna need something. I think something that helps us flute around our thoughts. So I'm gonna look in my magic music bag and see if I can find something. Oh, this is perfect. It's a yellow one. And there's a purple one. Fantastic. So here I've got two scarves, silky scarves. They can really fly on the air. Okay, you can get anything that you've got at home, some scarves, maybe an old t-shirt that you have or something. Something that is very light and can fly. Okay, and it can be any color that you like, okay? Right. As we play with the music, we're gonna go low when it's quiet. And we're gonna keep going up and up and up as the music goes louder and louder. Okay? Ready? Let's do it. Thank you. And the song we're going to listen to now is called Chicken Rhythm. Yes, you heard it well, it's Chicken Rhythm. So for this, we're going to need to be chickens. This song was written by a guy called Slim Galliard. He was an American jazz singer and player. So for this song, we're going to need to pretend we are chickens. So we're going to have a lot of cock-cocks. And I want you to have ready your wings, your chicken wings, and your chicken feet. Okay, it's gonna walk a little bit with really high knees, okay? And we're gonna be cocooing and being chickens around. Now you have to really pay attention. There's gonna be one part when the music, we're gonna hear a guitar playing a solo, and in this part we're gonna be swinging around, okay? Swing, 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 swing one leg. Swing the other leg, okay? And there's only one part of the song where we're gonna hear the word chicken rhythm. You need to be ready for this, okay? You can do it with your hands. And when you hear chicken rhythm, we're gonna go chicken rhythm, okay? Can you do it with me? Ready and chicken rhythm. Well done. You can use your hands or you can have a small percussion instrument. In fact, I'm gonna check to see if I've got one I can use myself. In my matching music bag. See? Oh! A tambourine! This is perfect. Okay, should we try it with a percussion instrument? Ready? And chicken rhythm. Nice! Okay, let's dance.
Chicken rhythm.
Had lots of fun, and I hope to see you all next week. Bye!